Hello everyone, welcome to Prime Number Channel. This channel will talk about blockchain technology, and all the related stuff. This video is the genesis video for this channel. So I'd like to talk about the genesis block of Bitcoin. It has been more than 10 years since the first block was mined in Bitcoin in 2009. Before we dive into the first block of Bitcoin, let me give you a quick introduction about the Bitcoin blocks and transactions. Let's take a look. So Bitcoin is a chain of blocks. So you can see here, each block consists a list of transactions. The list, it's not really the computer science data structure list. It's actually a tree. We can talk about this later. It's a Merkle tree. And each block has a hash reference to the previous block. So the block append to the end of the chain, on and on. So within the block, the transaction consists of both input and output. So let's zoom in for this. The transaction need to have, we call it input, actually inputs and outputs. So the inputs is where the Bitcoin, the unspent Bitcoin coming from. And the outputs is where the Bitcoin sending to. It's coming from an address and sent to another address. So the rule is you have to consume all the coins from the inputs and spend them or send them to all the outputs. Of course, you can have several inputs and several outputs. So among all those transactions, there are actually, you can say, two type of transactions. One is I have like 8 coins from someone and I send it to, let's say, Alice. Alice has 8 coins. Either he mined 8 coins or someone sent 8 coins to Alice. And this is input from previous transaction. And he want to send 4 coins to Bob. And that will leading to another 4 coins is sending to himself. So again, you have to consume all the inputs. So the remaining will go back to himself. There are some other remainings, which is the transaction fee. We can talk about this later. But there is a special transaction, which doesn't have any input. So the inputs in a transaction is a list in the data structure. So the list will be the empty list. But in the inputs, there is a field called CoinBase. I believe the CoinBase, which we use to buy and sell Bitcoins or other cryptocurrencies, their names is coming from here. The CoinBase field, you can fill in anything you want. And the output is the Bitcoin you just mined. So this type of transaction is a special transaction which create coins. It doesn't consume anything because there's no coin at the very beginning of the Bitcoin. And it doesn't have any inputs. The output is the coins created, which is mined. Okay, with that in mind, let's take a look at the first block. Okay, this is the block number 0 And you can see there's only one transaction in this block, and the output is 50 BTC. BTC is the symbol for Bitcoin. And it was the timestamp is 2009, January the 3rd. And it received in 2009, January the 3rd. And let's take a look at the only transaction within this block. I click on this, and you can see this is the transaction size, the weight, the receive time, and the most important field is the Coinbase field. The Coinbase field is the encoded of the information which decoded as the times January the 3rd, 2009, Chancellor Blink of second bailout of for banks. So let's take a look at the times. This is the times on January the 3rd, 2009. The headline is Chancellor Blink of second bailout for banks. Remember, 2009, this is the second year the economy crisis happened and spread to the whole world from United States. This is a kind of insult to the capitalism and the reason why Bitcoin has to be created by Satoshi Nakamoto. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you want to see in my video, and subscribe this channel if you like it. Thank you so much.